handle on that trunk and began to pull it away. And as he did, his glove slipped forward and she could see a long jagged scar on the back of his hand. It was the only identifying mark on any of those robbers. They wore gunny sack masks. They had gunny sacks pulled up over their boots so they wouldn't leave boot prints in the mud. Out comes the gunpowder, kaboom, the lid is blown off, gold nuggets everywhere, they gather them up, the robbers take off, the passengers get back on the stagecoach, and they make their way the rest of the way up to Grand Valley, California.
Unseen angels sent from somewhere to my soul. How can they linger ever? And the sacred seems unfold. Precious memory, how they linger, how they linger in my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred seems unfold.
Began to travel with them. By the time she was 20, she had landed in Liberty, Texas, where she was performing, and she met a man, Alexander Menken, who was an unusual combination. He was a musician, and he was wealthy.
If you are cold, off the plains, the snotty mules or steers, remember these before you start, like wise dried beef and ham. Beware of venison, turn the stuff, it's oftentimes a ram.
Monday, May 20th, this afternoon, we came to the junction of the Emigrant Road from St. Joseph and Owl Road. Both roads were crowded with emigrants. It was a grand spectacle when we saw the vast emigration for the first time slowly winding its way west. The country was so level, we could see the long trains of white-topped wagons for many miles. I have never seen so many human beings in my life. When we drew nearer to the vast multitude, all eagerly hurrying forward, I was frantic over the idea that every blade of grass for miles would be eaten off by the thousands of horses, mules, and oxen ahead of us. And worse than that, there would be only a few barrels of gold left for us when we got to California.